Hi, do you have a savings account at the bank? The interest rate is related to exponential functions. Let's see how. Suppose you have some money, say 200 euros, on a savings account that gives you 3% interest per year. How much money have you got after 10 years? And after 15 years? Or can we give a function that describes how much money you have after X years? Of course, we assume here that you don't make extra deposits or withdrawals. Okay, let's see. After year one, you get 3% of 200 euros interest. So you have 200 times 1.03 equals 206 euros. After year two, you get interest over these 206 euros. So 206 times 1.03 equals 212 euros and 18 cents. We can write this as 200 times 1.03 squared. After 3 years, you have 200 times 1.03 cubed euros, and so on. So after year X, you have 200 times 1.03 to the power X euros. This is an example of an exponential function. In general, an exponential function has the form A times B to the power X. Here A is some non-zero constant, and B is a positive number called the base of the exponential function. The number x is called the exponent. We will assume that b is not equal to 1, since this would just give you a constant function. The function we found in the example is indeed of this form, 200 times 1.03 to the power x, so a equals 200 and b equals 1.03. In the example, x is a natural number because you only receive the interest on your money once a year. In general, we would like to define b to the power x for any real number x. To do this, we need some properties for exponential functions. We already know calculation rules for power functions. These rules immediately give us rules of calculation for exponential functions with rational exponents. In particular, using the third rule, we know what b to the power x should be if x is equal to b to p over q, with q larger than 0. It is the qth root of b to the power p. So, what if x is not a rational number? Well, in this case, x can be approximated with rational numbers, and for rational numbers we know what to do. For example, what is 2 to the power the square root of 2? We can approximate the square root of 2 by 1.4, which is the rational number 14 over 10. Then we can approximate 2 to the power square root of 2 by 2 to the power 1.4, which is 2.63, etc. Using more decimals for the square root of 2, we get a better approximation. By taking a limit, we find 2 to the power the square root of 2. Let's have a look at the graph of b to the power x. First, we assume that b is greater than 1. We see that f is an increasing function, since for positive h, b to the power a plus h is a factor b to the power h greater than b to the power a. In the same way, we find that for b smaller than 1, the function b to the power x is a decreasing function. To see how fast an exponential function grows, we compare the graph of 2 to the power x to the graph of x to the power 11. Which function do you think will grow the fastest? Well, look at the graphs. It looks like x to the power 11 grows the fastest. But if we zoom out, we see that 2 to the power x catches up quickly and still grows much faster than x to the power 11. In fact, b to the power x with b greater than 1 grows faster than x to the power n for any number n. A base that is often used for exponential functions is the number e, which is approximately 2.718. Later on, in week 5, we will see that the function e to the power x has the special property that it is its own derivative. Now, let's summarize. An exponential function is of the form a times b to the power x. We have the rules of calculation for exponential functions, and an exponential function with b greater than 1 grows faster than any polynomial. You will see that exponential functions occur in many different applications. In the exercises, for instance, you will model interest rates and population growth with exponential functions.